Hey guys, namaste and welcome to my art world. You know what is this? This is what you call a dagger brush, and dagger brush will, you know, look something like this. You can see one side is tapered and the others, and you can have a broad brush strokes as well, correct? So I'm gonna use only this brush to finish this painting, and the second surprise is I'm gonna use a very little water, almost no water. So I'll be painting from my first layer, you know, with very less water, as less as I do in a last layer. Friends, I'm gonna paint a macaw today. This is a very cute little bird and which we all admire, but since it is a thick layer painting, thick on thick basically, so I'm gonna get some hard edges without a shadow of doubt. But yeah, so bear with me, you will see some, you know, good techniques, and I'm gonna give a voiceover with my time lapse so that you can understand what is happening and how I do, or anything to take away for you, I'll be glad, I'll be humbled. So guys, without further ado, let's jump into the time lapse. So as I always tell you guys, perfect your outlines and then start painting. And outlines you can do in three different methods. You can use the easiest one, grid line method. So you cannot possibly go wrong with grid line method. But one drawback is you need a scale, you need a lot of time to do that. And the second is compass method, which I also use. But try to do freestyle method, and you can use compass even in that as well, but freestyle is the best. Make somebody sit in front of you and do the outline, then take a picture from the same angle you are looking at, and then do the shading later on. So that is how, if you are drawing, you should do it. I'll make a series of video of how to do drawing. So this is acrylic painting, so once I have done the macaw bird, and I have started with the background, and my suggestion always to finish the background first and try to go little bit of inside of the outline with the background paint, because once you are doing the subject line, then you don't have to go back to the background again. So this could be very, very annoying for you. So guys, here as always, I have started with the dark areas, and guys, here you can see the, as I told in my so guys, you can see, as I told in the beginning, that I'll be using only that brush, but I apologize because I have used a different brush for the background in order to finish it very, very quickly. But for that, for the bird or the foreground, I haven't changed my brush, as I told. So normally people tend to go into, you know, smaller size brush, but I would always say try to go with broader, try to take a broad size brush and try to do the detailing, and until the very end, and while you are doing the highlights or something very very sensitive area or a very narrow area, then go for a small brush. Otherwise try avoiding the smaller brush. It actually it will not give you any control in the long run. Mixing the background is always with the less water, always with very very less water, and I that saves a lot of time, guys. When I started, I was very afraid of putting the color, so I was diluting a lot of waters with the paint. But eventually I have realized acrylic is something you can, if you paint a wrong color in some area and if you want to change it, you can go over layering and you can actually absolutely change that color. So don't worry about the mistake, try to be courageous, try to be really really creative. And whenever you are doing it, if you are using the reference point after 3 layers or 4 layers, please do not use, try not to use the reference point. Go in your flow, do the way you like it, and that is what I always do. And also it will in multiple time you can actually better describe your painting. So as I always say, if you don't have a description of your painting, then you are wasting your time, especially if you want to sell your painting in the market. I have gone into the darkest first and then gradually layer went lighter and lighter and lighter with the color, not lighter with the thickness of the paint. Here I am actually struggling to get the bird out of that background, because background is more prominent than the bird. So I'll be very careful with the thickness of the color. So more thickness of the color and more warmer color will take your subject really in front if your background is overpowering. So be careful and use a lot of thickness with the color. I am taking out directly from the bottle and using it in the canvas. So guys, here you might be thinking, top of a board, how am I calling it a canvas? If you have little idea about this is a canvas roll which I cut it into pieces, because it will help you whenever you want, you can frame it or you can even stretch it. So I would not say after painting you should stretch it, before the painting always you stretch it, but for me it will give a lot of flexibility financially, because always you cannot keep a painting and you cannot keep a painting stretched. This is how I operate, guys, because I don't want to spend a lot of money until there is no surety of selling. I am using a very very thick color. Now I have started using the tube color, and that is raw without any water. All my account, guys, like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, with the same name of tathaartlovers as my YouTube name is. Here I am going to go really bright to take the subject out of the background. So I was struggling because the background I have used very less water, guys. So that is the thing. But you can always do it, because at the end of the day you want everything bright and very charming to your eyes in order to attract the people or the audience who are looking at it. Here if you ask what is the focal point, I would probably say my focal point is the feather of the bird which is in the front, and in the feather I have used lots of different color like green, blue, yellow, red, which will be my focal point, and that's what I'm doing. And also the the tail, long tail of the front bud, I have used around I think 5 to 6 layers to keep a nice looking finish, and the highlights also I have concentrated, but my focal point will remain the same, which is the feather. One thing with I would come up with video very soon about the brushes, how to take care of your brushes, because when I started painting I have seen the brushes are going expired or not usable within 3 to 4 paintings, but right now I'm able to keep the brush longer. The brush strokes should be in a special way, and in this time lapse it might not be able to understand, but let me know if you want that video and you can save a lot of money by saving the brush. So now I'm focusing on the second brightest spot, because now I am going to give some highlight point, which actually brings the whole attention of the of my audience. Also I'm concentrating on softening the edges, which is required. So don't forget to check my description box with the links of my material which I have used in the entire painting, and you will give some sort of an idea, even you can buy from there. In this moment, while you think it is about to finish, then you'll see values which are not matching, but you cannot tell what exactly is not matching. So then you have to take a photograph, make it black and white, and then locate it with a marker. That's what I do, and if you can see it naked eyes, well and good. And sometimes it is very hard to catch the extreme differences, so I would suggest that. And then what you can do is again come back to your painting and do the necessary changes, and this is the final thing I do. And then again I do the highlights, guys, because in acrylic, once you have done the highest highlights, and after 3 hours if you check the same painting, the highlights goes little bit faded, or goes that brightness will not be there. So what you can do, I would suggest you have to do it again up. My last video, if you haven't watched it, go and check it out, it'll be end of the screen. And thank you for supporting me. It takes a little bit of effort to do this and execute these videos, so I would appreciate if you consider me a subscribe or like. So guys, thank you, happy painting, see you until next time, peace out.